Hi, my name is Vladimir. In this tutorial, I will show you how to force RGB color output on your M1 Mac. The end result is having your M1 Mac output RGB color to your external monitor instead of YPbPr, potentially making the colors more accurate and the text a bit more crisp, even on older 1080p monitors. To begin, click on Spotlight and open Terminal. In Terminal, type in open, then press on space, type in /library/preferences, and press return to open the preferences folder. Here is the secret to making M1 based Macs to change their display properties. Look for a file named com apple windows server displays playlist. You can also easily search for it by typing displays in the folder search. If you already have this file, then you can skip to the copy step. However, if you don't have the file in the preferences folder, here is how we can create it. First, open System Preferences and then click on Displays. Then simply change the rotation of your monitor to any given option. Your screen will temporarily rotate to the selected option. Don't worry, we won't keep this setting. It's only so that it will create the file for us. You can either wait for the countdown timer to reach zero or press on revert if you like to return your display back to normal. You might notice that the com apple windows server display file has now been created in the preferences folder. Now that we have the file, click and drag it to the desktop in order to copy it. If you right click on the file and open it in the text editor app, you will notice that it's a binary code and it's hard to understand and edit. We will first need to convert it to XML in order to edit it. To do this, we can use the built-in plutil option in your Mac. In Terminal, type in plutil, then press on space, then minus convert, space, XML1, press space one more time to add an empty space after the command, and simply drag and drop the file from your desktop. Press return and now the file will be converted into a readable XML file. Again, open the file with your preferred text editor app and you will notice all the options are visible in the file now. The most important option that we're looking for is the key pixel encoding. This one is responsible for the YPbPr color output and needs to be set to 0 instead. Go ahead and change the 1 into 0 on the integer below it. Next, we will also need to change the value for the key range. For this one, set the integer below it from 0 to 1. Those are the only two options that we need to change in order to get RGB color. You might notice that there are a lot more settings in this file that could be changed, but for now we will focus only on the color output. After you make the changes, save the file and close it. Now we will need to convert the XML file back to binary, as it was before. To do this, we will use the plutil option again. But this time, type in plutil, then space, minus convert, then space, binary 1, then press space one more time and drag and drop the file from your desktop again. Press return and now the file will be converted back into a binary file again. If you open it in a text editor now, you should see that it's back in binary. To make sure there are no mistakes and that it is a valid plist file, type in plutil, then space, then minus lint, then space, and drag and drop the file one more time. Press return and it should show up the result. If it shows OK, we can move on to the next step. Next, open the preferences folder again by typing in open, then space, then /library/preferences, and press return. Finally, copy the new file from your desktop back to the preferences folder. If there is an existing file there already, it is recommended to make a backup first, just in case, and then you can overwrite it. macOS might ask you to enter your password in order to be able to copy the file in this location. The new file should now appear in Library Preferences. That's it. Now you can go ahead and restart your Mac. And if everything is good, the next time it boots up, it should output in RGB color. You should be able to notice the more accurate colors and the text right away, and you can also check in your monitor's on-screen display menu to make sure. I hope you found this tutorial useful. Give it a thumbs up if you liked it. Subscribe if you want to see more videos like this. Click the notification bell if you want to get notifications. And thank you for watching. Feel free to ask in the comment section if you have any questions regarding this procedure.